Let's quickly see the format of profit and loss statement as per Schedule 3 of the Companies Act 2013. First, income, which includes revenue from operations and other income, that gives us the total income. Next, expenses. Now, this you can remember as CPC, EFD, others. So, C for cost of material consumed, P for purchase of stock in trade, then changes in inventories of finished goods, WIP and stock in trade, E for employee benefit expenses, F for finance cost, and D for depreciation and amortization expenses. And lastly, other expenses. Now, on deducting total expenses from total income, we get profit before exceptional item, extraordinary items and tax, then give effect for exceptional and extraordinary items, if any, then tax expenses, and we get profit or loss after tax. This will be from continuing operations. After this, we need to calculate profit or loss from discontinuing operation after giving tax effect, if any. And then the total of both gives us the final profit or loss for the period. Thank you.